Excited to be with you again, continuing on our journey of walking through the values of our culture playbook. To get started today, we have a special guest. Her name is Miss Allison Choi. Give her a hand. Come on up. This is Miss Choi. She went through the middle school. She has been a prefect. She is now one of the high school prefects that is like the liaison for the middle school, what we have going on at the high school, what we have going on at the middle school. And she has an announcement for you about something going on this Friday, and then she's going to pray for us to start us off today. All right?
Cool, what's up, guys? So this Friday, there's going to be an event up at the high school football field. It's called See You at the Pole. This is going to take during your break time, and this is going to be a time where the whole school gets to gather and just pray. If you guys want to come, you can come and see some of your middle school prefects pray over the school. And so, yeah, I'm just going to pray you guys in. All right, please bow your heads. Lord Jesus, I pray that you would bless this chapel. I pray that you would ease the nerves of any performers, God, that you would just give them the faith they need to perform and do their best. God, I pray that you would be with Mr. Mo and that you give him the words he needs to just speak to everyone. And Lord, I pray that everyone would have a good rest of their day. Amen.
So real quick, go ahead, Allison, you can go. The See You at the Pole is a voluntary activity. All of the high school will be on the football field during our break. And if you want to go partake in that, you have the opportunity to do voluntarily. There'll be a group that's going to meet at the middle school right at break time, and then you guys will walk over to the high school football field. Our middle school prefects are going to be leading, and anybody that wants to volunteer to go over there for that break. Now, unfortunately, what'll happen is you'll miss your break, but if you have your own snack and everything, go over there, partake in that, and it'll be a really good thing. Mr. Childers is going to be leading that, and we'll have more information in the pods about how you can get involved in that. Is that cool?
Yeah.
All right. Now, I've talked to you guys a little bit about worship, about what worship is, what worship is not, and that all of us are light bearers. We are made in the image of God. And he has given us faculties. He's given us the beautiful ability to move, to think, to express all of this humanity. And so sometimes we come into chapel and we'll sing and we'll express our gratitude and our worship and we'll show the Lord worth and appreciation for what he's done for us. And sometimes we need to just do our thing, whether it's in sports or playing our instrument, play our instrument, or move our bodies. Today, we get to see our middle school dance class perform, and it is a form of worship for them. So let's give it up for our middle school dance to come and open us with a dance, all right? Get one more round of applause. Give them a That is so good to be able to get them up on the stage and express all that. You see, they're all wearing smiles, they're moving their bodies. God gave us the ability to do that. And we can use it for expression of worship. We can also use it for things that are not necessarily appropriate. But we choose to use this as worship. So ladies, good job. Good job. All right, guys, so we are continuing with our culture playbook. And we have three major values that we're talking about this year. We're talking about trust. And when we opened up, I shared my story. We talked about trust and that trust is the foundation of building relationships. It's what really sets the tone for our culture. And we talked about that trust needs to begin with all of us looking in the mirror and making the decision of the man or the girl in the mirror and who we want to be. So can we be trusted and can we extend trust? Right? We had a good talk about that. That was awesome. But today, we're talking about respect. And respect is very important. And respect is pretty broad. But I'm going to ask you a question. Okay? What is respect? Let's have some dialogue here. What's respect? You can raise your hand. I want to hear from you. Who's got something? What is respect? Yes. Ooh, I like that. Valuing others as you value yourself. That could be a good definition of respect. What else? What else is a form of respect? Yes, young lady. Giving your full attention to them. I'll just let you know, when you're at the dinner table and you have your phone and you just turn it face down, that's not giving all your attention to them, right? We need to exercise practices to be able to eliminate distractions and give our full attention to each other sometimes. Great point. What else? Let's do a couple more. Yes, up here in the I think this is fifth grade, right? Who is that, Corinne? Hi, Corinne. Go ahead. Let's hear what you have to say. Treating others the way they should be treated. Very good. That's in alignment of what was already said before, but the two different ways of saying it, but blending those. I think you guys are getting this. Let's do one more. One more. Yes, up here. Paying attention to your teachers in class. That, amen. Right? Everybody say amen.
Amen.
That's what I'm talking about. We can have a little amen in here. Yes, respect is all of those things. Respect is also paying attention to who's ever up here talking during chapel, right? Also, whoever's talking in chapel, paying attention to you. All of this is respect. But let's look at a definition. A feeling and or a what?
Expression.
An expression of deep admiration for someone or something elicited by their abilities, qualities, or achievements. In other words, respect can be a feeling. It can be an emotion. And it's elicit means it's brought on by something. According to Google search, all right, I typed in respect, and I got some interesting searches. I also went to dictionary.com and Merriam-Webster.com. So this would be our American English understanding of what respect is. Would you guys agree with this?
Yes.
Yeah, to some degree. Would you also add some of these other things that we heard? Yes, very good. So respect. Now, I don't know if that's actually worship, but I would probably lean toward it not being, but it's still a unity, and it's unity in an idea, unity in an idea of this thing, respect. Now, I want to tell you a little bit about this song, all right? This song, it was released in 1967. It was released during the time of the Civil Rights Movement. That was a big time in our nation. And it's about a young, confident, independent woman telling her man that she doesn't see any reason why he needs to disrespect her, right? And he needs to understand what respect means to her. Because at that time in our country, women were not really given equal rights. And we also know that the African American or the black community was not being offered equal rights. So this song, and this idea of respect was, this song was elevating this idea to challenge us in this country to find respect amongst each other because we are equal in our human value. TCB, interesting, takes take care of business. Do the right thing and do what needs to be done. You need to take care of some business and respect each other. Put in the work to know each other. Sock it to me. Interesting statement in this song is give it to me. Give me the respect I deserve. That's what she's singing about. And this song has become a legacy. It's like a civil rights anthem, but that was back in the 60s. And Miss Aretha Franklin passed away last month, but this song lives on because it's a big idea. It really challenges us. So it's cool to have fun with it, but we need to get to the deeper meaning of it. You guys understand that? Cool with that? All right, so just this is a timeline of the Civil Rights Movement. There was some big stuff going on in our country where there was some lack of respect in our human value. And this timeline just shows us, and we're not going to get into this, that this song was written right in the middle of this. It really brought about a new idea to develop a new culture in our country, not just in a school. And there was this thing going on with women. Women were being more exposed in the media. They were getting more jobs. They were starting to be put in positions to be equal with men. They were showing their value was equal to men in the workplace. And this is a good thing. This is a great thing. But I want to share this quote with you. I love this from Aretha Franklin. She says, "We all require and want respect." How many of you want respect? I'd say that's all of us. Okay, put your hands down. Do we get respect by walking up and be like, "Hey, Tyler, you better respect me, dog"? No, it doesn't work that way, does it? Right? But we all want it. I want him to respect me. I want to respect Tyler, right? So this is something that we we earn from each other, but we also extend it, right? So we all require and want respect, man or woman, black or white. It's our basic human right, Aretha Franklin. Now, that has brought about an understanding of respect from a, I guess, a worldly perspective. But here, we want to look at it, what does the Bible say about respect? Well, the Bible, there's this passage in 1 Peter that says that we are to show proper what?
Respect.
Proper what?
Respect.
Proper respect to everyone, love the family of believers, fear God, honor the emperor. In other words, what this passage is saying is that we need to honor those appointed over us. This comes out of 1 Peter, and this down there in the left corner, it's tamao. Tamao, not tomato, tamao, right? That's the Greek word, and it means to respect, it means to honor, it means to value. Notice there's something missing here, though. It's just something we extend just because of another human's value, not because they've done something. That's a big difference between the way we look at it biblically and the way we look at it culturally. Right? So here's what we're going to do. We're going to dive into a couple passages here today. I've got three readers. We're going to have Tyler Kacharian, Finley Shinnick, and Ethan Bergman come up, and they're going to read from Matthew chapter 7, this scenario where Jesus is actually teaching on what we call the Sermon on the Mount. And there's this one passage where he doesn't say the word respect, but what he's teaching about is respect. And that respect begins with the man or the woman in the mirror. So I'm going to invite Tyler up to start us off. So Tyler, would you come up?
Do not judge, or you too will be judged. For in the same way that you judge others, you will be judged, and with the measure you use, it will be measured to you. Why do you look at the speck of sawdust in your brother's eye and pay no attention to the plank in your own eye? How can you say to your brother, let me take the speck out of your eye, when all the time there is a plank in your own eye? You hypocrite. First, take the plank out of your own eye, and then you will see clearly to remove the speck from your brother's eye.
Ask and it will be given to you. Seek and you will find. Knock and the door will be opened to you. For everyone who asks receives. The one who seeks finds. And the one who knocks, the door will be opened. So in everything, do to others what you would have them do to you. For this sums up the laws and the prophets.
Enter through the narrow gate. For wide is the gate and broad is the road that leads to destruction. And many enter through it. But small is the gate and narrow the road that leads to life. And only a few find it.
Some interesting things in this passage, okay? Jesus said, do not judge. And thank you guys for reading. That was awesome. Do not judge, or you too will be judged. For in the same way that you judge others, you will be judged. The way you measure other people is the way that you will be measured. Jesus is trying to teach us that there is an equality amongst us as human beings. Yet, we are very, very different. We look different, our hair is different, our skin color is different, our height is different. And when there is a banter that we have. The fact is, I'm bald, right? Y'all know I'm bald, right? Well, technically, I got a big cul-de-sac on my head. My hair doesn't grow right here the way I wanted to when I was a kid. And so it gets all thick on the outsides, and so I shave it. Otherwise, I feel like I look like I'm 80 years old, and I'm only 45. So I shave my head, and everybody knows I'm bald. Now, there's a banter. I get played with, teased, oh, you're bald, Mr. Moe's bald, this and that. And it's cool. That's okay. That's the fact and the reality. But when somebody starts talking about my baldness from the perspective of as I'm a lesser person, that's problematic, isn't it? That's like judgment on who I am as a man just because of my hair or lack of. We have a tendency sometimes to do that with our height, our color of our skin. And what Jesus is trying to tell us is that we need to measure each other with equality, people. Life would be so much better if we did this, if we lived in this principle, all right? Then he goes on to say, you worry about the speck of sawdust in your friend's eye, but you pay no attention to the plank of wood in your own eye. This is that whole principle of looking at the man in the mirror. There's something I've learned about you guys over the course of the years. Even as you move on to high school, there's something you really dislike very, very much. And it's hypocrisy. Hypocrisy. See, back in the Greek days, when they would do their plays on stage, they would put on masks, and then the actors were being someone else, and they were a hypocrite, meaning they could be someone else. They were posing, they had on a mask. And Jesus goes on to say, check this out. He says, how can you say to your friend, let me take the speck of sawdust out of your eye? How can you say this while there is a big old plank sticking out of your own eye? You hypocrite. You're faking. He's challenging all of us to look in the mirror and examine. We dislike people that say one thing and then do another. You guys dislike that, don't you? I know a little bit about you that if somebody comes up here and they're telling you to do something and you even smell or even have a hint that they're not living it in their own life, you're like, dude, I'm done with this guy. I'm done with this woman because I don't think they're telling me the truth. And you don't like that. But what happens is, because we're human, we just want to get real here, is that as much as we don't like that, some of us, because we're human, have a tendency to live that out in our own life. And so Jesus is challenging us to look in the mirror and examine if we have hypocrisy, if we're saying one thing, living another, and then bring it into alignment. Bring our belief, what we say we value, and who we are, our actions, and bring them together to be a whole, complete person. Right? Then he goes on. First, take the plank out of your own eye. It's all metaphorical, right? There's not really a plank in the eye. Okay? Then you will be able to see clearly how to take the speck of sawdust out of your friend's eye. If you learn how to grow yourself, you then have more to offer someone else. Okay? So let's keep going. Ask and it will be given to you. I'm going to read the red, you read the black. Okay? Ask and? Search and? Knock and? Will receive, will find, will be opened. He's not talking about asking and you'll receive that new shiny car. Sorry. Jesus is talking about the internal wisdom, knowledge, and power to do the right thing by other people. That's what he's talking about. And to access the power of the Holy Spirit that he gives us. That's what he's talking about. How many of you guys want to live in power? How many of you guys want to live in power? Power to do the right thing. Power to say the right things. The power to have the energy to get my homework done when I don't want to. Oh, now all the hands go up, right? Okay. Yes. That's an internal power. When you ask, when you search and you knock, you give your mind over to wanting it that bad, you're going to find it. But you got to put in the work, guys. Got to put in the work. In everything, treat others how you want them to treat you. This is what is written in the law and the prophets. Jesus holds a high value in Scripture. He's referring back to the Old Testament. This is something that has existed since humanity. Treat others how you want to be treated. That's an action that you have to decide to make. Now, enter God's kingdom through the narrow gate. The gate is wide and the road is narrow that leads to ruin. Many people go that way. Unfortunately, many people decide to go through the gate that is ruin. But we don't want to do that. The gate is narrow and the road is wide that leads to life, and only a few people find it. Sometimes doing the right thing and standing against wrongness, you feel alone. I have felt that, but it's the right thing to do. When everybody's trying to suck you in and you're saying, here's who I am, and the world around you is trying to pull you in a direction that you know is wrong, It gets lonely sometimes, but that's where the Lord comes in. If you have a relationship with him, that's where your power comes from. And that's what he's offering us in this teaching. So I'm going to say the yellow, you say the white. We value
respect.
Our behavior. Our outcome, you guys are responsible for the response of your behavior. E plus R equals O. Events plus responses equals outcomes. Our behavior is us. We got to make that decision. Coming back to our culture playbook, we've talked about trust. We are unified. When we respect each other, we serve one another. And the next time we get together, we're going to talk about growth. Mrs. Meyer from the high school is going to come over. She's the associate head of spiritual life for the whole school. She's going to talk about growth. We're going to start to close here. You guys tracking with me today? All right. Last word on respect. The part I do like about this definition from Google search or dictionary.com or Merriam-Webster is that it does say that respect is a form of admiration for someone or something that's brought on by their abilities, their qualities, or their achievements. We get to observe something today. We started off with our middle school dancers, and we respected that. It was awesome. There's some admiration there. But our middle school dancers get to look forward to our high school dancers. They've been here. Most of the high school dance team has been at this middle school and has gone through, and now they're up there, and our middle school gets to admire them, and then they have somebody they admire, and it's just a continual chain of respect. So I ask that in a spirit of respect, you guys watch our high school dance team do their thing, and they're going to close us out. All right? Here we go. And they move around, and they're being in uniformity. That's like an expression of that unity. They have to trust each other to know where they're going to be around the dance floor. They have to respect each other in a way that they're going to do their part to bring entertainment to us. And then doing it in a manner that is showing worth to the God that's given them the ability. So we had worship, respect, and trust, all that going on at the same time. Right? That's awesome. So let's take this away. Let's not walk out of here today and forget respect. Let's walk out of here today and make decisions that we are going to be respectful to one another and that we dictate our culture, and it's a place we want to come to every day. Are we cool with that? All right, let me pray and I'm going to get you out of here. Lord Jesus, thank you for an amazing teaching from 2,000 years ago that is still relevant to our lives today. I am so grateful that you gave your life to come and give it up for us. And all of our shortcomings, you spoke some hard things to us and to the disciples, but yet you also love us through it. And I pray that we would be a respectful community that does that with each other. I pray that these students understand the value of trust, they understand the value of respect, and that they make a choice, Lord. Put it in their heart, stir them up, that they would display their behaviors and treat each other with that respect, Lord. So with that said, we do this in Jesus' name. Amen. You are dismissed. Have a good day. Amen.